Mr. Shankar advised me to give some data available with me. You can say I share some data which is available of power sector in India. You all might be aware that at the time of this country independence, our installed capacity was just 1.4 gigawatt, means hardly 1400 megawatt power plants at the time of independence. And now it is more than 3 lakh megawatt. This 300 gigawatt we already crossed. 1950 electricity boards were formed in 1950 as per Electricity Act 48. Till 1990, the state government sector owned plants were 74% of total plants. And then now in 2016, share of state, center and private is almost equal. But the private sector plants are 40% in this country. With the captive and IPPs, their share is about 40%. But of course, per capita consumption in 1990 was hardly 320 units per capita consumption, which is now more than 1,000 units. Means you can say that the demand is increased by 3.5 times from 1990 to 2016. But in 1990, when the total installed capacity was just 80,000 megawatt, it became 1,40,000 megawatt in 2003. And now in 2016-17, it is more than 3 lakh megawatt, which is including the figure given by Chairman Punjab Electricity Commission, that is 58,000 megawatt. That is RE installation in this country. And you will surprise that the peak shortage in 1990 was 17%. 1.7 was the shortage of power in this country. Now in 2017, it is peak surplus 3.7%. I think you people might be aware about the Vidyut Pravah, an app which is available in our smartphone. Yesterday itself, the power was available during daytime. It's the summer season of this country. During daytime, it was available at 1.10 rupees to 1.40 rupees during daytime. Power available in exchange, power exchange. It's really very surprising. And the most interesting figure is installed capacity is 3 lakh megawatt, and the peak demand in the year 2016 was just 1.56 lakh megawatt. The highest demand went up to 1.56 lakh megawatt against the installed capacity of 3 lakh megawatt. Precisely, it is 3 lakh 9000 megawatt installed capacity. It means the PLF of the power plant, which was just in the year 2010, it was 73% PLF. Now, in the last month, it was 60%. Means we have to brought down the PLF from 76-77% to 60%. You know why? Because of renewable energy. Though I am in this field since last 35 years, but sometimes I also feel that when we talk about the RPO, it is nothing but talagiri. Whatever amount of electricity your state has, but you'll have to have the RE power to meet out your RPO. What these people will do? If you will further decrease the PLF of this thermal power plants, what will happen? Per unit cost of generation will be increased. That will affect the complete tariff structure. But why we think that we should reduce the generation through thermal power plant because of the poor performance of this technology. Being engineer, being scientist, we all should feel that, we all should know that what is the efficiency of this thermal power plant. It's really very, very poor. यदि मैं उस समय लेबोरेटरी में होता तो शायद इस टेक्नोलॉजी को कभी भी लॉन्च भी नहीं होने देता कि जब तक इसकी एफिशिएंसी ना इंप्रूव हो जाए. वी व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द दिस ट्रांसफार्मर, वी नो दैट द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर इज नाउ 97% 95%. हम कोई भी इक्विपमेंट, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विपमेंट, व्हेन वी बाय इट वी सी व्हाट इज द एफिशिएंसी. इट इज मोर देन 90%, देन वी सी दैट इट इज गुड एफिशिएंट प्रोडक्ट. बट वी नो द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ थर्मल पावर प्लांट. See, thermal technology we use one term, that is station heat rate. And what's the average station heat rate of thermal power plant in this country? Can anybody just share it? Station heat rate of thermal power plant? No, 2400 is for ultra mega, and the ordinary in old NTPC power plants it is about 3000 kilocalories. That is the station heat rate. And what does it mean? 3000 kilocalorie means this much of heat is required to generate 1 unit of electricity. And 1 unit of electricity is 1 kilowatt hour, which is 860 kilocalorie. Means you are producing 3000 kilocalorie of heat to get 860 kilocalorie of electricity. So efficiency at generation point itself is about 25%. But that too at generation point, and at consumer place, because since the power comes through the transmission, distribution and all network, means the GNT loss, average GNT loss in this country is about 22-23%. So after considering this GNT loss, again it comes down to about 18-19%. So look, science ke students hai, engineers hai, ये लोग इस बात को जानते होंगे. हम लोगों ने बड़े स्कूल में ही पढ़ लिया, एनर्जी कैन नॉट बी जनरेटेड, कैन नॉट बी डिस्ट्रॉयड, इट इज जस्ट ट्रांसफॉर्म फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म टू अदर फॉर्म. जब ये खत्म नहीं होती, पैदा नहीं होती, एक फॉर्म से दूसरे फॉर्म में सिर्फ चेंज होती है, तो देन वेयर दिस 82% 83% गॉन, इट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू पोल्यूशन. जब आप एक स्विच ऑन करते हैं अपनी लाइट जलाने के लिए, इफ यू आर यूजिंग द थर्मल पावर, तो स्विच को ऑन करने के बाद में आप कितना कितना कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, कितना कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड, कितना सॉक्स, कितना नॉक्स आप एटमॉस्फेयर में छोड़ते हैं. सो वी आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर पॉल्यूटिंग दिस एनवायरमेंट. हमारी डिमांड हम बढ़ाना चाहते हैं. यार्ड स्टिक टू मेजर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द कंट्रीज पर कैपिटा कंजम्पशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. पढ़ाइए, हमने 3.5 टाइम बढ़ा दिया 90 से अभी तक. अभी मैंने आपको बताया कि 300 यूनिट पर कैपिटा कंजम्पशन से हमने 1000 पे हम लेकर के चले आए. मींस वी इंक्रीज द पोल्यूशन. व्हेन वी सेम से दैट इन थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स वी हैव रिड्यूस द इंपोर्टेड कोल, यूज ऑफ इंपोर्टेड कोल, व्हाट डज इट मीन? वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द पोल्यूशन अगेन, बिकॉज द कोल अवेलेबल इन यूर कंट्री इट गिव्स यू 35-40% फ्लाई एश. And when we use the imported coal, it gives you the fly ash in single digit, 79%. So that is the scenario because of which we should think of using, we should think of encouraging this renewable energy in this country. Actually, what we have done in Haryana, Kareda, I'd just like to tell you that I joined this Haryana in February this year itself as chairman Haryana. And prior to that, I was working with Chhattisgarh, Kareda as director. I worked there as director for 16 years, 1-6. Things have already told about the losses in use of mega-sized solar plants. I am also against that. If really we will achieve the target of 100 gigawatts solar through megawatt size, you can imagine what will happen with the transmission grid. The complete system will be collapsed. Because if you are working with the solar in megawatt, if you are working with the wind in megawatt, it means ultimately you will feed this power into the common grid, transmission grid. And when you talk about the green corridor, transmission corridor, again, beimani hai. You can't transmit your power through the separate grid, which is, it is not HVDC. Because transmission of power requires reactive power, which you can't get with the solar grid. In HVDC, reactive power is not required. But in the common, now, the transmission lines which are available, reactive power is required. So you'll have to have, you'll have to synchronize your solar and wind generation with the grid. Then what's the solution? Solution is off-grid. Or grid-tied system, rooftop solar system, that is the only solution. In Chhattisgarh, what we did, in Chhattisgarh, we covered more than 1800 villages through solar system, 24/7 supply through solar. In that, the size of the plant were from 10 kilowatt to say about 100 kilowatt. 2,000, about 2,000 primary hostels, about 650 primary health centers, about 350 community health centers, 100% collectives, 100% district hospitals, 100% Jila Panchayat Bhavan. So we covered all the maximum government buildings through solar. High court building, Vidhan Sabha, Mantralaya building, you can just go and see plants are, rooftop plants are there in megawatts. So this is the solution where we will not interfere with the common grids. Here in Haryana, this Haryana government has drawn very good policy, the solar policy. When I went through this, I found that this is the best solar policy in the country, you can see. Of course, we have recently started the execution in a big way, but the policy, it says that the plant which will you will set up in Haryana will get the status of industry. Means all the facilities, incentives which otherwise you are getting in your industries, same you'll get if you are setting up the RE plant or the solar plant. 20% of the tender quantity reserved for small solar power plants, the capacity from 1 megawatt to 2 megawatt. It's very a special thing which is mentioned in this policy. Price preference of 2% for the projects of capacity 1 to 2 megawatt means again you'll get the incentive if your plant size is small, because we know that you can't compete with the power plant of 200 megawatt. Transmission line up to distance of 10 km will be provided free of cost. I don't think this facility is available in another state. Few states are giving this facility. And then change of land use and environment clearance not required. Even certificate is also not required, that this clearance is not required. In few states I heard that, like in Chhattisgarh, when you apply, that sir, this permission is not required, they say okay, you give an application to get this certificate that environment clearance is not required. Then exemption from internal development charges, scrutiny fee and infrastructure development charges, exemption of billing, GND losses, cross subsidy, reactive power charges, no extra charge if you are setting the power plant, solar power plant in Haryana. Exemption in stamp duty for registration of rent, lease deed of the land for projects. You buy the land, you will not required to pay the stamp duty in that. Surplus power generation from the solar pump sets to be purchased by the Haryana Power Purchase Center, HPPC. That is also one incentive which is available in Haryana. Installation of solar power plants has been made mandatory by the government in certain categories of the buildings. That regulation is already there. I'll show you some regulations which are available in our website also. And then notification in this regard has been issued. SP plant capacity 3 to 5% of sanctioned load has been mandated. Provide this notification. So this is the notification which is already available. And then now net metering regulations. It is also very good regulation. There were some difficulties in getting the net metering in Haryana, but in the last one month, you can also apply for getting the net metering benefit online. You can apply online. People are getting the sanction of subsidy within a week. I think this is the best example now in Haryana, because you are applying and getting the subsidy sanction within Marfing, it's really a good movement in this sector. Even the net metering also, within 3 to 4 days, people get the net meter. They are allowed to purchase the bi-directional meter from the market, from the approved or registered contractors of the DISCOMs. Then even DISCOM is also supplying this bi-directional meter from their stores. If it is not available, you can buy from the market. So this problem is also resolved now. And now allows consumer to bring the XLPG to the grid. The power exported to the grid may be credited to the consumer account. People can just go to Faridabad, Gurgaon, Rohtak, and not many places you find that people now sitting at the plant above 100 kilowatt. In one university of Ambala district, plant solar power plant of 3 megawatt has been commissioned, recently commissioned. There are 6 plants each of 500 kilowatt, and in one medical college it is of 1 megawatt. So that is tremendous. Means the growth of solar is really picking up very nicely. And now I give the example of Germany, where the total installed capacity is now more than 44,000 megawatt solar installed capacity. And 85% of that is rooftop, grid connected. So similar kind of thing can be developed in this country. If you think of setting up 100 gigawatt, it would not be possible. But if you think of setting up the plant in off-grid or in grid-tied way, that is the only solution. So these are green incentive. Very surprising that you'll get the net meter benefit also, and then you'll get the green incentive also. If it is commercial industrial, you'll get 150 per unit. But suppose you are generating 500 unit per month, in your electricity bill, you'll get the incentive of 500 rupees. If it is domestic, then you'll get the benefit of 100 rupees for 500 units. With that unit will be net metered also, it will get this decision. So these are some benefits. Solar policies also available in our this website. I'll be available here. These are few photographs. You can see beautiful picture here using this solar plant on the rooftop. With subsidy, installation of last year is 5 megawatt. Without subsidies, it is 47 megawatt. Since we got the sanction in the month of December, January, so before that, since it was mandatory, people started setting the plant and then they applied for the subsidy. So without subsidy, they have installed 47 megawatt. Total is about 52 megawatt installed. And this is the plan that this year we will cover all government buildings. 100% government buildings will be installed, will get the solar power. For that, we already completed the survey. The total potential is about 25 megawatt. Once we'll meet out the requirement. And then online portal is available, software for online sanction of subsidy is already available, and link with this DISCOM site. Ground mounted solar power plants program is executed by HPPC, 29.8 megawatt, they already installed. Rockford, Nirmani, capacity 100. So this is total 125 megawatt power plant, power utilities, utilities are in process to invite tenders for purchase of 300. Megawatt in addition to that. Then off-grid solar, as I told you, that you already made the plan for it. So this is all. I'll be available in this conference for the whole day. We'll discuss. Thanks to the organizer for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to interact with this presentation.